Hi again, everyone. This is Hassan Jaffer. Here's a tutorial about my latest Astro Calendar. And we've added a lot of things in it. I think it'll be quite exciting, actually, for you. The first thing you notice when you go in this, in the main page, you'll have a mobile version. So you just click on the mobile version, and you'll be presented by this view. And where there's a home button. And below that, you'll see all the planets. It says Sun, Moon, Mercury. And as you hover over it, it'll give you the meanings of it. And Venus. But you should start with from Pluto, actually, because this is once in a lifetime. And it says once in 246 years cycle, 10 to 20 years in each house. So it stays there for a long time. So you can understand the long term. And everything seems to revolve around Pluto. And it's like almost like day and night. You know, it's the daytime. It slowly becomes evening and the nighttime. Then it becomes a dawn and morning and bright daylight. But the intermediate steps, you can't really tell when it's happening, but it's a complete transformation. Whether it's in your marriage, in your finances, in your career, or in your health, wherever it's happening, but everything revolves around Pluto. Neptune is the next one, is the most inspirational. It's the saddest areas of your life, but also the most inspirational ones. And whenever you can change it into compassion for other people, when you do humanitarian projects, that offsets the theme. Or when you're near the ocean, near the water. And all you do is when you go in it, for example, this is President Obama's astro calendar. So when you click on Pluto, it'll tell you exactly which house it is transiting. So here you can see the meaning of what the planet means. And then you can go here and it says exactly what's happening for the next several years and events around you which are beyond your control. Sometimes even life-death experiences involving your contacts and friends will completely reevaluate your goals, etc. So this Pluto's transiting is 11th house. Now, below this, below the dates, you'll find all the months there. Even if you go to December, it stays in there at the same thing. In fact, if I change the years also, you can also go back to the years. So, for example, Saturn. Uranus indicates when there are sudden upheavals or the changes which appear like upheavals. That's one of the aspects of Uranus, that you hear the rumblings of the earthquake, but you don't act till the earthquake finally hits. And it's a need within you to break free from restrictions in that area. If it's a sixth house, for example, then you need to break away from, if you're in a stagnant 9-to-5 routine job and suddenly you want to just rebel against it, but you've been wanting to do that for a long time. So Uranus indicates either some upheaval or that you know, when you get new technology, that seems to offset the Uranus theme. If it's a seventh house of marriage, same theme, you may be in a stagnant relationship, for example, and unless the partner becomes involved with marketing and computers and space technology and the high-tech and inventive type of things, for example, that's all Uranus, also sudden events in their life. Similarly, Saturn is a very important barometer of one's success. And as you can see, the meanings right there says that Saturn represents the areas which you need to strengthen. And this is a side of you where you'll set yourself up for all kinds of disappointments and lessons of life. It's the second house, for example, and you've been having a great time spending all kinds of money everywhere, and suddenly Saturn comes up and you find short of funds. So it's a very important barometer of one's career, actually. And if you look at Barack Obama's chart, so when you click on Saturn, you'll see it shows 9. Now when it goes to December, if I go into December, it shows 9, but you'll see that it goes into the 10th house on the 13th and will stay there for a number of years. This is the peak of one's career when you get a lot of recognition. So from this December, it seems that it does have the recognition aspect coming up. Right now it's in the 9th house, which is a major test of legal matters also. Similarly, Jupiter, so you see the meaning of it as you hover over it, mouse over, and then it immediately, when you click it, it changes. So here's, if you want to have any more children, for example, or it's an excellent aspect for the children, actually. They're having a great time. They saw Jupiter in the 5th house. So you still have the moon transits. So when you click on moon, it has the same theme as before. You have all of this theme. And the sun is another important one, actually. You can see for the whole month where it's going. So, for example, here's the month of January. In this case, it stays in the 3rd house. When you go into February, it goes in the 12th house, which is not the best month for health matters. In March, it's like a brand new beginning. It goes in the 1st house. Similarly, when you go into December, it's in the 10th house, which is a very lucky period for him. Actually, if you go to November, and I'd said this at the time of his election, actually, that in November, from 9th, it goes to 10th house. Every year, all his life, around the 20th of November, it's an aspect of fame aspect. That's why, you know, that the sun was right on top of the chart when he won the election. And every November it'd be like that, actually. So you can see for yourself the sun It's a yearly cycle, exactly same dates when it enters a certain house. So you can actually, for example, the month of October for Barack Obama is number 8. It's a very lucky month financially. This should be the tax year end for yourself also when the sun is in the 8th house. So just go over the months and it'll tell you exactly which month it's in. Now you can still go back to the main calendar. When you click on the home, you'll go to the main calendar here. Here it says you still have your chart here. And now with the planets out now, and the bi-wheel, which shows you the inside is your chart and outside where the planets are now. And there's a calendar also you've added. So when you go there, you can see the whole calendar. Just like a regular calendar, you can see everything here. And it opens up in its own window. So afterwards, you can just finish it. Now, for example, if you want to see publicity for Barack Obama, for example, for yourself also, when you click number 10, that'll show you exactly which months you have the fame element. There are so many things you can do here. At the bottom, all of these are linked together now. If you want to see Mercury, where you intellectually engage in those areas, when you click it, it goes back in this one. By the way, this is also the mobile version. So I'm showing it on the computer, but you can open it up on an iPhone or Samsung and everything right here. So you have the moon position here as well. And the main thing is I've added all the planets and the fact that you can use it for mobile. This is a very important theme. And you may not have to use the other function. You can still use these other things. For example, if you click on this reset button, this is the moon position on a daily basis. As you can see, it stays on for about 3-4 days or 2-3 days in each sign. And now when you want to find somebody's birth date, and let's say anybody's birthday, somebody's born 1972, for example. So click on 1970, then you click on 72, and then if the person is born a certain, for example, here's August 9th, for example. So here's August and 9th, and you click on Leo, all the personality is right there. So you can see the personality, you can see the world forecast on that date, and what to do when the moon is in a certain position. So if moon is in Leo, this whole aspect applies to you. That's a very interesting thing. It's a lot of things. And for astrologers, as you mouse over, you will see all the planets changing right here also. So basically, this part applies to you, all these icons, that the best time financially is when it's number 8. So you can see in January, February, March, this is how you can see. You can also go back in time. And this is the normal way that we had the show moon transits. As we go, you can see the meanings. And if you have more family members, you just click on show family moon transits, you'll see everyone there. But I'm really excited about this one, that when you click at the bottom, for example, here's Venus. See, as you go over Venus, it tells you exactly what it means. And then when you click on it, it'll tell you where Venus is right now. And wherever it is, there's peace and harmony and artistic things in that area, that time. For example, if it's second house, you end up spending on fashion, on clothing, etc. If it's in your, for example, in August for Barack Obama, it's in the 5th house. It's a very positive aspect for having children that time, anything pertaining to children that time. So this was a brief introduction to our new latest astro calendar, which is also a mobile version. When you click on the main menu on the left-hand side, that takes you to the main for the computer. But if you click below the mobile version on your name, that'll take you to the mobile version. And then you can select whichever planet you want to see. And understand your long-term mission by clicking on Pluto first. With Neptune, you'll see the saddest but the most inspirational areas of your life. Uranus, the areas where you need to make the major changes. Saturn, to understand where you are in life. You're going up or down, or you should be focusing on yourself or in your career. And Jupiter, where the opportunities, the luck element is. Mars, the areas where you might experience some strife, but that's because you haven't confronted it, that you need action in that area. Venus, for the areas which are the most artistic and beauty and harmony and peace in that area. Mercury, where you should intellectually plan in that area. And the Sun, for the monthly cycle, aura, and it remains the same every year, all your life, exactly the same dates. And Moon, which stays only for about 2-2.5 days, the 28-29-day cycle, so you can keep on, you know, observing it every month. And that's a very important one for rectification of the chart, to find out what time you were born. And the feedback that you give me with this, it helps me to understand your chart better. It's a very, very important key for our life coaching program, because rather than just depend on me to tell you things about yourself.